After defeating two monsters decks, I'm 2-0 in this standard daily event, Black-Green Constellation. This hand makes me nervous, but it's a keeper. Even if I don't draw lands, I can play Elvish Mystic into Caryatid and then start playing my 3-mana spells and my black spells. Plus, I'm on the draw, so I might just hit a land. Stranger things have happened. Wow, another basic mountain lead-in, but this time looks like I'm against a dedicated red heroic, which could be a good matchup for Black-Green Constellation, although my sideboard right now is not geared for it. I have 0 Drown in Sorrows. Given that I lost the die roll, I think if my opponent has great draws, I could be a bit of an underdog in this match. So my opponent upkeep Titan Strength and scry to the top. Alright, I mean, I can't block. Yeah, this is not looking good. Mono Red Heroic's not a good deck to miss a land drop against. Let's say I block this soldier token. All right, now I'm at 5, and I have 1 land in play. Okay, so if I had Satyr Wayfinder, we might be in business. As it is, all I can really do is play a Courser, I think. The Courser go up to 6. And just try to block something. Alright, up to 7. I'm dead to any spell. Well, that's okay. You're sort of meant to lose game 1 against Red Heroic, especially if you lose the die roll. Problem is, I don't have a whole ton to bring in off the sideboard, like a couple extra removal spells. I get to take out Furiko, which is pretty bad. Let's see what we got. Well, Thoughtseize is awful. Furiko's awful. Eidolon's pretty bad. So, Reclamation Sage versus Hero's Downfall versus Eidolon of Blossoms, I guess, is what I'm deciding between here. Downfall might actually be the worst of them. Now, I guess there's almost no way Reclamation Sage can be better than Downfall. Unless he has Eidolon of the Great Revel, Mogus's Warhound. Yeah, I guess even the chance that he has Eidolon of Great Revel makes it worth keeping Reclamation Sage in. Let's say I cut 1 Downfall and 2 Eidolons. Give this a try.